It's my side or no side, ain't no in-betweens. All my niggas serve that fatty, we just want the green. Load up them yappers, broad day, if you play with me. Yeah, fuck my enemy. It's my side or no side, ain't no in-betweens. All my niggas serve that fatty, we just want that green. Load up them yappers, broad day, if you play with me. Yeah, fuck my enemy.
What's going on, guys? Queen City Bullies Aaron checking in. We back with another video today. Real quick, I just want to talk to y'all about C-sections versus natural births when it comes to these American bullies. I've been getting a lot of comments, a lot of people DMing me asking how this litter was born, how do I go about birthing my litters. In the past, I've definitely done a little bit of both. I've done my fair share of C-sections as well as natural births. This litter right here off of Believe in Gabbana was born by way of C-section. I took her in on her 63rd day from the first AI. We did three AIs. We skipped a day in between each AI, but I took her in on the 63rd day from the first AI and had them do a reverse progesterone test. And she was ready to have the pups. She was at a 0.5. I could kind of tell that she was starting to go into labor, but I just kind of wanted to beat her to it, because as you can see, she had 9 puppies. And one of the reasons why I do C-sections, and I'm sure a lot of breeders do C-sections, is because the way we breed these dogs, like me personally, I breed for bone mass and girth, you know, structure as well. But when I put a breeding together, I expect for the puppies to be super thick, super boned up, super girthy. So with a litter like this, you see she got 9 puppies. There's really no way that she could have pushed out all 9 of them puppies. You know what I'm saying? So I did what I felt like was the right thing, and took her in and had the pups pulled out and did the C-section. Now, as y'all know, I got another litter off of Bubby and Princess Jasmine. We got 3 males off of that litter. She actually had 5 puppies though. So she had 5 pups. 2 of the puppies didn't make it. They came out stillborns. Like I said, she had a natural birth. 3 of the puppies came out good and healthy, but 2 of them didn't make it. Now that's one of the reasons why I would do a C-section as well, is because in my experience and all the times that I've done a C-section, I've never done the C-section and they pulled out dead pups. So anytime I've done a C-section, the pups always come out healthy. Now I feel like both C-sections and natural births got they ups and downs. Like as far as when you do a C-section, they put the mom to sleep and cut her open, obviously, to take the pups out. Well, when you do that, the mom is pretty much out of it, like, for the first day at the least, you know. So you really gotta pay her close attention, make sure you watch the pups, keep a close eye on the pups and stuff like that, because she pretty much gonna be out of it, you know what I'm saying. I done personally had a bad experience where I dropped a litter, a 10-piece, and I had it via C-section, and I wasn't keeping a close eye on the pups and the mom. I walked out, left them unattended, and with her being out of it from the C-section and stuff like that, it really hadn't kicked in that she was a mom yet. You know what I'm saying? Like my vet, they'll send me home with the placentas, the sacks from the puppies, and a sandwich bag, so that way when mom wake up and she you know what I'm saying, the medicine wearing off, you can offer those bags to her, and then eating those bags to kind of help her understand, like, oh, okay, it's time to get busy with these puppies and stuff like that. Because if she was having a natural litter, she'd do the same thing. She'd, when each puppy come out, she gonna clean them up and eat that sack. You know what I'm saying? So, but with them C-sections though, that, like, when you do a natural birth, they not gonna really be out of it like that. You know what I'm saying? They be up and ready to have the next puppy and stuff like that. But with my experience with them, natural births is not all the time do all the pups make it. Like I said, I had 2 stillborns in this litter. Like, you know what I mean? Puppies can get stuck. You know, they might have half of the litter or just about the whole litter, and then one or two of the puppies get stuck. So when you had that happen, you done had them push out all these puppies and then turn around and then they still got to get cut open. So I don't know, man, just over the years and throughout me having so many litters, I'm starting to lean more towards the C-sections. At first, I ain't really want to do it. One reason was because I was looking like I ain't really want to cut my female open. You know what I'm saying? But the more I think about it, having them, like, say, for instance, she got 9 puppies. I got them separated. I got 5 other puppies right here eating right now. And then you got these 4 puppies over here sleeping. I'm going to rotate them out in a minute. But you got these 9 puppies right here. There's no way she could have pushed them out. It's just no way. You feel me? And then even if she could have, she would have been in labor, like, all day pushing them puppies. So how, in my opinion, like, as I think about it, how much worse is doing a C-section, which probably only take about an hour, you feel me? It's in and out for real. Versus having them be dropping them puppies all day. Because I'm sure both of them is equally as painful on the female. And then when you do a C-section, you know, they gonna send you home with antibiotics, pain medication, and all that. When you do a natural birth, bro, your female just on her own. You feel me? Whatever natural home remedies or whatever you might give them, concoctions or whatever like that. But man, for the most part, it's just, you know what I mean? Her and them puppies, no medicine, no nothing. But, you know, to each his own, it's nothing wrong with having natural births. If they was in the wild, they'd most definitely have these births naturally. But at this point, these dogs, man, they man-made. Like I said, we breeding them specifically to have more bone, more mass, more girth, bigger, blockier heads. So the expectation of thinking that they're going to push that caliber of puppies out, it's just not going to happen. You know what I mean? You can get away with it every now and then. Like I said, I've done it. But really, when you think about it, like, what's really the reason for you not to do the C-section? Other than you feeling like you don't want to cut the female open. But like I said, it's no worse than sitting there and watching her push out 8, 9, 10 puppies over an 8-hour, 10-hour span. You know what I'm saying? I done seen females be in labor 12 hours. You know what I'm saying? Like that's no better than just doing the C-section, like, at this point. So, and then too, like, when you think about it from a breeder standpoint, the investment, you know what I'm saying, paying all that money for these dogs, spending all that time waiting for them to grow and mature, to be old enough for you to breed them, and then they go to drop a litter and you lose them pups because you don't want to do a C-section. For real, I feel like it come down to 2 things. You not wanting to spend the money on a C-section, you feel me? Or you just feeling like you don't want to cut your female open. But at the end of the day, like I said, you breeding these dogs the way we breed them, with this mass and this bone and this girth, you're going to end up having to get a C-section anyway. I done had that happen where, like, oh, I'm doing a natural birth with this litter. And then come time for the female to go into labor, she pushing, but ain't no pups coming. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, damn, now I got to do the C-section. Rush to the vet, get the C-section anyway. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, bruh, at this point, it's just safer to do it this way. You know what I mean? The natural births is all fine and dandy. They definitely, I've had great success with them, for sure. I've had a good amount of success with the natural births. But like I said, man, going forward, I'm pretty much gonna be doing C-sections. I like how smooth this one went. Really, all of them have went just as smooth. I think this was like the first time that I really showed y'all. I don't know if you noticed, like, if you go back and watch the videos when the pups was first born, they was like whining a lot. That's another thing too. They be having that medicine in them as well, because when they get a medicine to mom, obviously it's gonna affect the puppies as well. So that's why they was like whining, because they was kind of out of it too. You know what I'm saying? It took them like 2 hours for me to get them home and stuff like that, for them, and that medicine to wear off for them to start latching on. But that's just a part of, that's just how it go. You know what I mean? Sometimes when you do natural births, they don't eat right away. But as long as they staying warm and everything like that, then that's good. So, but yeah, man, I just wanted to tap in with y'all, let y'all speak on that one time.
Let me put some more of these puppies in there for her.
I just wanted to speak on that one time, because I've been getting a lot of questions in the DM and in the inbox about that. But the C-sections, man, it's all a part of the investment. Like I said, if you're going to spend all that money on the dog, it makes no sense for you to try to do a natural birth, and then, you know, you have mess around and had a luck that I've been having, and you lose pups. Because I ain't going to say that had I did a C-section with Princess Jasmine, that those other two pups would have lived, but who's to say that they wouldn't? You know what I'm saying? And it would have definitely been worth paying the money for the C-section, because it's really not about the money, to be
completely
honest with you about the situation. It's not really about the money, for real. It's about making sure that these dogs is healthy and that they thrive them. You know what I'm saying? Anything less than that would be a complete disappointment, for sure. For sure.
Let me show y'all these other pups real quick.
They over here knocked out. Look how chunky they is, though, y'all. These Bubby and Princess Jasmine puppies looking amazing. Look at them, man. That blue boy then got so chunky. Y'all sleeping. Look at that blue boy and how chunky he done got, boy. I'm loving this black trap boy, too. Y'all know that piebald blue trap boy. He sold the other two boys, this blue one and that black trap boy. They both still available. So y'all can tap in on them. They 10 or 11 days old. Don't quote me on that. But, man, as you can see, Bubby and Princess Jasmine showed out, man, with the three-piece. I can't complain at all on that, John. Man. But yeah, I ain't gonna hold y'all up. I just wanted to give y'all an update on these pups and just let y'all know as far as how we birth these litters around here. You can do natural litters. I've definitely done and had success with it. Like I said, if you go back and just watch my videos, I done took my fair share of losses, regardless, C-sections or natural birth. So I'm taking a risk either way. I just feel more comfortable, more safer at this point doing C-sections. I feel like I always try to do my best, do my part, you know what I'm saying? Do everything I can do on my end, and then let the rest, let the chips fall as they may. But I feel like as long as I do my best, try not to cut no corners, you know what I'm saying? Because like I said, it's really a big reason for like, hush, it's okay. A big reason why a lot of people... All right, we back, y'all. My bad. That was my fault. Damn Amazon, man. Messing my video up, my wife ordering all these packages. But anyway, like I said, though, I've definitely had success both ways, doing natural births and C-sections. But going forward, man, at this point, I'm going to go the C-section route, man. Because like I said, it's a lot on them, regardless, making them give birth and stuff like that. Uh-oh. There you go, mama. It's a lot on them, regardless, having them birth all these puppies, man. So I just feel like I don't rather cut corners and stuff like that. I just want to make sure I give it my all, do the best I can, and make sure that these puppies come out healthy and thriving, man. As you can see, they all doing good. They getting big. They gaining weight. I got them all in there now. She got puppies everywhere. She got puppies to her left, puppies to her right, puppies in front. Puppies every freaking where, y'all here. Yes, sir. Uh-oh, don't go nowhere, baby. Come back. Well, yeah, man, this is life with two litters, y'all. She got a 9-piece right here that I'm doing my best to help her whip. And then right over here, we got Princess Jasmine 3-piece. So I'm rotating them out. You know what I mean? They feeding, they eating. Then Jasmine will be up next. I'll bring her out, put her in. Look at that girl right there. She's such a good mama, boy. Line them up and get them together. Drop a comment, man, if you got a good mama like this, man. This girl right here, she goes to work. I can't ask much more of her. I just can't. At this point, I cannot ask much more of Gabbana. She doing her thing, man. Look at her. Look at her. Yes, sir. We on the road, y'all. This day 3 for the pups. They doing extra good. I can't complain. They doing extra good. They looking good. I'm very impressed. Loving what I'm seeing. Y'all see how they all can't eat at one time? There's nipples everywhere, but, you know, I see they struggle to eat together because it's just so many of them, and they so strong and muscular. They pushing each other out the way. They all on top of each other, so I've been kind of rotating them out. That way we making sure that everybody eating. I like to start with the smaller ones. Well, I don't feel like they're smaller. They're just some of them a little more compact, I'm going to say. A few of them is a little more shorter and compact, so I start with them. And then you got some of them that's just super chunky, so I'll let them eat second. But that's how we living, man. It's life with American Bullies over here at Queen City Bullies. We doing our thing. Fingers still crossed. Y'all make sure y'all pray for us. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell. And make sure you follow me on Instagram. We on the road to 10K on Instagram. We like 1,200 followers away from hitting 10K. That's one of the goals. I'm trying to make that happen before the end of the year. Don't know if it's going to happen or not, but regardless, we're going to keep it pushing. You feel me? But yeah, man, I ain't going to hold y'all too long. Just check these puppies out, man. They're doing super good. All these lilac tries and blue tries. I'm so in love. I'm just in love, y'all. I'm in puppy heaven over here. I ain't had no sleep in 11 days. But, man, I'm just going. I'm high off the vibes right now. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. Look at that puppy trying to... Ooh, wee, you see that? Yes, sir. On that note, man, I'm gonna end the video. Y'all see these muscled up pups? Y'all better tap in. A lot of these pups will be available. I'm keeping one for sure. I know y'all been on my ass about keeping one of these puppies. I will be keeping one. Can't say which one I'm gonna be keeping. My brother been tapping in with me. My brother gonna be keeping one as well. And the rest of these jokers will be available to the public, man. So y'all stay tuned. If you're interested in these pups, you can hit me up. I'll put you on the list. We can go over the pricing and everything like that. And then that way, when we ready to start taking deposits and stuff like that, y'all be ready. I'll hit you up. And everything will be a go. But before I do tap out, I want to show these pups to y'all one more again. Because two of these pups are available as well. That black tri boy right there. Matter of fact, I ain't even going to hold y'all. Let me pick these jokers up. What's up, big guy? Look at the neck on that boy right there. I know, bro. I know. I really messed up picking you up. I know. Because the only time I mess with y'all is when it's time to eat. And then look at this big old meatball right here. Ooh-wee. 10 days old. They might be 11 days old. I ain't gonna lie. 10 or 11 days old. But they eyes just open. As you can see, they thick in the body. Just the way I like them, man. Yes, sir. Bubby and Princess Jasmine. Believe in Gabbana, y'all. We doing it up. Y'all drop a comment, man. Let us know what y'all think. I'm Aaron, Queen City Bullies. I'm going to get with y'all on the next one. Yes, sir.